The show goes on!
To have it be the final destination, I always love coming here.
And so I have very high expectations, but it's always great to be back. I always love any excuse to come back to Japan. For me, is very special because I love it here.
They were great. They're great. So excited, so fun, and
Look, we're happy to present this film to Japan. I think you're going to understand that ultimately this is a cautionary tale. This is not a reflection of how to be. It's how to get lost. So, you know, enjoy the ride, and hopefully you have a great time watching this movie.
さあ、それでは早速ですね、まずは日本の記者の方々に向けて一言ずつご挨拶をいただきたいと思います。
We're very honored to present this film here in Tokyo. I think this is my 9th time here. It's always a wonderful experience. And this is a film that I'm very proud of. It's about 7 years in the making. And I hope everyone goes out and watches the movie and enjoys it.
This is my first time in Japan, and I'm very... honored to be here with these two talented gentlemen, two heroes of mine, and your country is beautiful, and you have embraced me with open arms, and I thank you.
I'm very pleased to be here to help launch The Wolf of Wall Street. It's a special film that Leo and I made, and Jonah. I've been coming to Japan, I think, since 1979. It's always very special for me. I wish I could spend more time here. And I do hope that the film is embraced when it's released, embraced by the audience. It's a film that we think at times is very, very funny, but it's about a serious matter.
今回日本に皆様揃ってアカデミー賞ノミネートということでお越しいただいておめでとうございます。本当に私たちも嬉しい限りなんですけれども、私からの代表質問を先にさせていただきたいと思います。まずレオナルド・ディカプリオさん、先日のゴールデングローブ賞主演男優賞もおめでとうございます。
ありがとう。 Thank you。
そしてアカデミー賞は4度目のノミネートということで、やはりそれを引っ提げて日本に来ていただくっていうのは私も嬉しいんですが、どんなお気持ちですか？
It's wonderful to be recognized by the Academy, especially for a film like this, which took so long to finally get made. A film that I think takes a lot of risks. A film that you know, ultimately is a cautionary tale, but one that you won't see financed from the Hollywood studio system very often. So,I'm honored that this film got recognized, as well as the gentleman to my left and to my right, because I think they did some brilliant work in this film. And it's, you know, you never know what to expect. We don't know what's going to happen at the awards. Nobody does. But I think the real gift was the fact that we got to make this movie in the first place. That's the real reward.
Okay, thank you. 続きましてジョナヒルさんにお伺いしたいと思います。今回は見事助演男優賞もノミネートということで、かなり強烈なドニー役で私も印象残ってるんですけれども、演じてみてどんな印象が残ってますか？
Thank you. I'm very honored to be nominated for an Academy Award and especially amongst two of my heroes and you know, Donnie is a very complex individual, someone with no impulse control, someone very out of control, yet somehow very entertaining. And it was just a beautiful experience to work with these great men.
そしてマーティン・スコセッシ監督にお伺いしたいと思います。今回作品賞、監督賞を含みます5部門でノミネートになりました。さらにプロデューサーであるレオナルド・ディカプリオさんからぜひ監督をというふうに依頼を受けたというふうにも聞いております。監督がこのジョーダン・ベルフォードの自伝を取ろうと決断した一番の理由って何だったんでしょうか？
Well, I think the biggest attraction really on taking on this project, which took me a little while to come around to, was certainly in the enthusiasm Leo had for the project and the character. And I knew that if I could figure a way of shaping the film the way I thought it could be shaped, I knew that his enthusiasm and just the passion for making the picture, I just knew that if I did it every day, I'd be working with people who want to be there and want to do the work and enjoy it.
ありがとうございました。では最後にレオナルド・ディカプリオさんに私からの代表質問最後になりますね。今回なんですけど、この会場、この映画に引っ掛けましてになるんですが、ニューヨーク、ロンドンに並ぶ世界最大証券取引所になるわけです。で、年間取引額が600兆円を超える東京証券取引所なんですが、実は映画の記者会見というのがハリウッドスターでは初になるんですね。で、レオナルド・ディカプリオさん、こちらの会場で会見ということで、今ご覧になってみてどんなお気持ちですか？
It's amazing to be here, especially presenting this film in particular, which is about the direction not to go in the stock market. Our film is definitely a cautionary tale. It's a reflection of Jordan's past, where he spiraled out of control and was obsessed with making money in the wrong way. So.I'm glad we got to do a film that was an extreme cautionary tale because marketplaces like this affect a lot of people's lives, and it's important to do the right thing and have a strong moral foundation in this marketplace.
はい、ありがとうございました。では今日いらっしゃっている取材陣の方からの質問タイムになるんですが、それでは早速手を挙げていただけますか？はい、じゃあそちらのメガネのスーツ着られている男性の方からいきたいと思います。
ウォールストリートジャーナルの大部と申します。セックスだとかドラッグだとかアメリカでもとてもコントローバーシャルな映画だと聞いていますが、日本人には少しショッキングな感じもしますが、このテーマは日本人にとっても、日本人やアジアの人にとっても大事なテーマ、レレバントなテーマであると思われますか？
I think that the film was done as a reaction to what happened in 2008. In this film, as I stated before, Jordan loses his way. Now, what's so great about working with somebody like Martin Scorsese is that he'sunafraid to put the darker nature of these characters in an incredibly authentic way on screen and not be didactic about explaining to an audience what to think. For me in particular, this lifestyle, this debaucherous sort of hedonistic lifestyle, is something that we wanted to explore on a cultural level In my viewpoint, and in many viewpoints, this attitude is incredibly destructive, especially in today's economy, and we've seen the result of that. I think Japanese audiences will hopefully embrace the film and realize this is one man sort of pushing himself to the utter extremes in the search for wealth and power. But I think what a film can do on an artistic level and a cultural level is sort of shine a mirror back to society and ask ourselves what motivates us. And hopefully this film does that, because I've never read a more honest account of somebody that looked to their past and was unflinching in their honesty about how far they got lost. And it's something I think very important to say about the world we live in today. Oh, is my mic off? My turn was done, I suppose. I also think that a little bit of controversy is a positive thing, because it creates a dialogue. And I think that was one of the main motivations for us to do this film. I think that a lot of people, when they've seen this movie, they see this lifestyle and what Jordan sort of represented, which was the mismanagement of other people's wealth in order to give in to his own hedonism, and ultimately what happens to him towards the end of the film is a very interesting one. But it is a reflection of the truth. Everything in this movie is true. The reaction, I think, has been garnered from the fact that the main protagonist didn't get punished properly. But as we've seen in the past, that is a reflection of the truth.
The question is, would an Asian audience care about the film or how they react to it? My question to you is, wouldn't an Asian audience care about what's valuable in life, to make you think about, to watch a story and make you rethink what the values are really in life? The values of compassion with each other, values of love and taking care of a family, or is it success measured only by how much money something makes, no matter how you get it? Lying, cheating, stealing, you get the money, that's the success, that means you're okay. I think any audience would be interested in that. And as far as being a shocking film, why should it be polite? I mean, they're not polite. People are kicked out of their houses, people are robbed, people are taken, all their money is taken from them. Why should we be restrained in terms of projecting on a screen how they live?
テレビ西日本 GB の沙織と申します。レオナルド・デカプリオさんに質問です。今回主演だけでなくプロデューサーも務めていらっしゃいますが、今回この伝説の男の物語というどの部分に惹かれたのか教えてもらってもいいですか？
There's really been two projects in my life that I've had an immense passion to put up on screen, and I was fortunate enough to have both of them directed by the man to my left. That one was The Aviator and the second was this film. I never really question why I'm compelled to play a character or where that passion comes from. Obviously, ever since 2008, and seeing just a reflection of the world around me and the immense need for consumption and endless expansion, this character sort of embodied a single human being that indulged in everything. And I couldn't get this character out of my head for a long period of time. And I knew that he was the only person to direct this film, because more so than the plot, more so than just the script, it was the characterization of who these people were. And that takes, a collaborator that gives the actors time enough to explore and seek out the film that we're ultimately making through the characterization of these people in an honest way. So other directors had interest, but I waited for him to do it, because I knew we were both going to go on an exploration process together. And this character was one that I just couldn't get out of my head. And I suppose it was because in a lot of ways, I see this attitude in the world around us, and it's surreal to me. Just like watching this movie is surreal, looking at the world around me sometimes seems bizarre. This endless quest for wealth and material objects. And this is this guy epitomized all of it. And Jordan was so honest in his depiction of himself in this novel. It made for a very compelling film. It's not often where people are that forthright in incredibly embarrassing information about themselves.
テレビピアノ大川と申します。ジョナヒルさんに質問です。ジョナヒルさんとディカプリオさんのコンビネーションが本当に素晴らしかったんですが、撮影中に最も印象に残ったエピソードがあれば教えてください。
Thank you.
ありがとうございます。
Leo is an amazing actor and one that makes other actors around him better. And I think, you know, the story is a lot about our partnership and our friendship and the building and ultimately the deterioration of that. And so for me, the most exciting scenes to shoot together were the ones where that was kind of falling apart towards the end.
Well, tell him about how you made him eat the sushi when he was sick.
Yeah. And there was a scene towards the end where we're eating sushi as our empire is kind of crumbling. And it was written as I was supposed to eat this piece of yellowtail. And the first take, I said, why don't you eat the last piece of yellowtail? And for the rest of the evening, Leo had to eat take after take the raw yellowtail until he was sick. And Marty and I were laughing.
No. Well, he was really sick. I mean, and you in the middle of the take would say, how about that tuna?
Yeah.
Take the tuna.
It's yeah. delicious, right?
But I think it was originally my line that he took. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I had to eat about 50 pieces of yellowtail.
Okay.
目覚まし土曜日の高見と申します。よろしくお願いいたします。レオナルド・ディカプリオさんに質問です。ディカプリオさんがここ日本でベルフォートのようにド派手にお金を使うとしたらどんなことに使いたいですか？
日本じゃないといけないですね。日本ですね。
If I was, I'm not gonna isolate it to Japan, but you know what I would do if I had billions upon billions of dollars? And this is gonna sound very sentimental, but it's true. I would go protect the last remaining jungles and rainforests and coral reef systems on Earth. I would buy them and make them national parks. That's what I would do with a lot of money. Because ultimately, bigger homes and airplanes and artifacts don't have that much meaning to me.
これ日本に限らないんです。
I know that sounds sappy, but it's true.
Okay.
こんにちは、日本テレビのジップの岩崎と申します。レオナルド・ディカプリオさんに質問があります。これまでにもディカプリオさんはさまざまな役をたくさんこなされてきたかと思うんですが、もし仮に俳優になっていらっしゃらなかったらどんな仕事をされていたか、例えば株式ブローカーになったということはあり得るんですか？
I definitely wouldn't be a stockbroker.
まず株の売買にはなっていないと思います。
The marketplace is still very confusing to me.
僕はすごく今も混乱してます、その、市場というものにね。
The two things that I... There's this thing called career day when you go to junior high school. And you're supposed to try to figure out what you want to do with the rest of your life and therefore what college you want to go to. And I always thought ofacting as a great passion, but no one could ever sustain that as a job. That was the main thing that I wanted to do, but I didn't understand that people actually did it for a living. So the other two occupations that I chose were travel agent and marine biologist.
Travel agent.
Yeah, because they said travel agent because they told me you could get free tickets.
Okay.
So that's what I wanted to be.
映画雑誌スクリーン編集部の近藤と申します。よろしくお願いいたします。マーティン・スコセッシ監督にお伺いしたいと思います。今回のベルフォートなんですけれども、実在の人物です。しかも、まあ、古くに生きた人ではなく、実際に今も生きている非常にリアルな人物です。そういう人物を描くために心がけた点はございますでしょうか。
I think in terms of dealing with the, a character who's very much alive, I did that with、Robert De Niro, myself, and Raging Bull. Jake LaMotta is still alive.、Henry Hill was still alive, and we did Goodfellas.、for me,、what was there in the script of the character, and also was taken from the books written by Jordan, for me, it's not necessarily being the real Jordan. The real Jordan we can't、attempt to put on a screen.、it's really the spirit.Of who he is and the way he thinks. And、that's something that、is what, that's what guided me in trying to portray him on screen with Leo.
それから大変申し訳ありません。一人一問かと思いますけれども、ぜひレオにディカプリオさんにお伺いしたいと思います。今回の役も含めて、これまでのキャリア、非常にリスキーな、もうこれまでのキャリアが吹っ飛ぶようなリスキーな役を、平気でやられてますけれども、あなたもその俳優としてその辺は、恐れというものは知らないんでしょうか。教えてください。
As far as taking risks, I would just say how would、any artist expect to entertain an audience if、the person doing the work was、bored and uninspired themselves? So I think that、you have to take risks to remain dormant and repeat yourself ultimately is a long road to not being able to work because people will lose interest. So.
マーケットリサーチ会社フィスコの高尾千浅と申します。ディカプリオさんにお伺いします。長い年月温めてこられた作品ということですけれども、中でも一番時間やお金を投資されたシーンについてエピソードを教えてください。
Time and money.
The scene?
She's asking what scene did we take, put the most time and money into.
ちょっと監督に相談してます。
Do you know the answer to that?
No.I think we don't look at it that way. We think it's the entire picture, the budget of the film. And、we had a good schedule. We made it on schedule. Can't think of anything to...
I think his whole life was、so bizarre and surreal. It was almost like a modern day Roman emperor. And we wanted to put all of that into the film.We wanted to make it a grand American epic about a main protagonist who gets lost in the quest for power and wealth. So、I don't know if there's one particular scene. Maybe the boat crashing scene could be one.
The boat crashing, yeah. That took some time.
And it also symbolized his demise in a lot of ways, his yacht sinking into the Mediterranean en route to...laundering more money. So I suppose that would be the sequence. Arigato.
どうもありがとうございました。
Arigato.
Arigato. 拍手をお送りください。ありがとうございました。You niggas ain't breathing, you gasping. These niggas ain't ready for action. Ready for action.
So when we say, okay, three, two, one, pull!
From the theme song,
my
little
bit of cheese. Thank you so much, 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 thank
you. On behalf of Mr. Scorsese and Mr. Hill and myself, we hope that you see this film, Wolf of Wall Street, and enjoy it.It's a wild, wild ride. I know you'll be thoroughly entertained.And it's always an honor to be here in Japan, and、I look forward to coming back again soon, as we all do. Ain't that right, guys? Thank you.